Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is synthetic fiber and plastics, we were talking about the plastics. What are plastics? And we are trying to understand that the plastics, what kind of a shape they form and how it is formed. So basically, we have seen here that plastic is also made up of a polymer. It means that a lot of small units of the plastics, they combine together to form plastic, or we can say a small unit of atoms, they combine together to form molecules, and these molecules again combine together to form the plastics. Now you see here students, what we have seen that there is a carbon and hydrogen. This carbon and hydrogen atom, they combine together and they form a molecule. Now you see, the two atoms, they combine together to form a molecule. Now still this is a small unit of the molecule. Now these molecules, they combine together to form a polymer. So here this molecule is what? It is a monomer, and the monomer is formed of two atoms, that is carbon and hydrogen. Okay, so carbon, hydrogen, they combine together to form the polymer. Okay, to form the molecule, they combine to form the polymer, and that polymer is known as the plastic. Okay, now if we talk about the plastic, we have seen that the arrangement can be linear and the arrangement can be cross-linked. So we have seen here student that if the arrangement is linear, it means they are arranged linearly like this. It means they can slide over one another, slide over each other, and due to which they are little bit flexible in nature. But if we talk about the cross-linked, so in case of a cross-linked, you will find that basically they are cross-linked with each other, you know, and in such a case, they are tightly arranged, you can say, from all the sides, and due to which they cannot be remolded, or they are not very flexible, but they are stiff, they are hard, okay, and tough, strong. Okay, so this stiffness or this flexibility in the plastic occur because of the structure only, and the structure is, one is linear and the other one is the cross-linked. Okay, now on the basis of that, the students, we have broadly classified the plastics into two, and that is thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Okay, now let us write it. Types of plastics. Types of plastics. So here, plastics can be broadly classified or categorized, you can say student, it is broadly categorized into two types, and that is thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Okay, so thermoplastic is there and thermosetting plastic is there. If we talk about the first one, and that is thermoplastic, so let us start with this. Try to understand that what is there in case of the thermoplastic. So in case of the thermoplastic, it is a kind of a plastic student which when heated and then formed, it can be remolded again. It means you can give the shape again to this thermoplastic. So it is quite flexible. Okay, so we can say that we can remold it again. Molding means trying to giving shape to something, and remolding, it means even after giving the shape, again we can change the shape. Okay, so here The first thing, now you see student, we can say that if it can be remolded, it means it is what? It is quite soft. Okay, and this is because we are able to remold it. Okay, so it is a plastic. It is a plastic that becomes soft and moldable, soft and moldable when hot. Okay, so when it is hot, it is quite soft and it can be molded, and then when it get cool, it set. Okay, so sets in when get cooled. So you can see here student, this is a kind of a plastic which is quite soft, and at that time when it is hot, it can be moldable. Now it gets set because when you mold it and try to give shape to it, and then when you leave it, what will happen? It will set into that shape. Okay, so it is moldable and can be given to shape. Now after giving that, it can be molded again easily. Okay, so see here, what I want to say that if suppose an object is there, and when you heat it, then if a plastic object is there and when you heat it, when it is very hot, at that time it is in the molten state, okay, in the liquid state. So at that time, suppose you want to give shape to that particular plastic, then it is easy to give. So that is why it is written here, it is soft and moldable when hot. So when it is hot, at that time we are able to give shape to it, and when you leave it after giving the shape, it will set it sets in when get, so it will get set when it get cool here. Okay, now if suppose again you want to change the shape, so is it possible to change? Yes, in case of the thermoplastic, again by heating it, we are able to change the shape or whatever the desired shape that we want. So we are able to change it according to that. Okay, so we can write it that it can be molded. It can be molded repeatedly. It can be molded repeatedly after heating. After heating. Okay, so it can be molded after heating into desired shape and size. An example is there, so we can write the example also. Example is polythene. Polythene is there. Polythene. Then PVC. PVC is known as polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride is there. Then polystyrene. Polystyrene is there. So these are some of the examples of the thermoplastic. Let me tell you what happened in case of the thermoplastic student. It is a plastic which is soft, and it can be molded, it can be given shape when it is hot. Then when you lift it, it will become cool and set. Now if suppose again you want to change it into another kind of a shape or size, then you can do it. Okay, it means you can mold it repeatedly. It means it can be remolded again and again simply by heating it and giving the shape or the size that you want, that a person want. Okay, and What are the different type of a thermoplastic which can be remolded again? So polyethylene is there, then polyvinyl chloride is there, and polystyrene. So these are what? These are the different kind of a polymers. You can see, students, the name itself started from poly. It means polyethylene. So actually here ethene is a molecule which is repeated. It means the different molecule of the ethene, they combine together to form the polyethene. So ethene is the monomer, and many ethene combine together to form polymer, that is polyethene. Here you can say poly is given, vinyl chloride. So vinyl chloride is a molecule, and the different several vinyl chloride, they combine together to form the polyvinyl chloride. Then styrene is there, so different molecule of the styrene, they combine together to form the polystyrene. Okay, so polyethylene, PVC, polystyrene, these are the different kind of the polymers are there, plastics are there, which are the thermoplastic. Now let us see the next one, student, and that is the thermosetting plastic. Okay, in case of the thermosetting plastic, student, you will find that this plastic can be remolded once, but it cannot be remolded. It can be molded once, but cannot be remolded. Okay, so the next one is the thermosetting plastics. So here, if you are having the thermosetting plastic, first of all, we are able to mold it into the shape or the size, whatever we want it. Okay, and then we will lift it so that it will get set and cooled down. Now, is it possible again for us to set it or to give the desired shape or the size that we want in case of the thermosetting plastic, student? No, we cannot. So, we will say that here the difference between that of the thermosetting and the thermoplastic occur, that we cannot remold it in case of the thermosetting plastic. Okay, so we can write it here that it is a plastic which can be molded into a desired shape, into a desired shape only once. What does that mean? That once set cannot be remolded again. Okay, so once it gets set, it cannot be remolded again. And now if you compare the thermosetting plastic with that of the thermoplastic, you will find that it is comparatively rigid, it is comparatively harder and stronger. Okay, so we can write it that it is comparatively harder and stronger than thermoplastic. Okay, so comparatively harder and stronger than thermoplastic. What are the examples today? Bakelite is there. Bakelite
and melamine.
Okay, so bakelite is there and melamine is there. These are some of the common examples of that of the thermosetting plastic. So you have seen here, student, the difference between the two. First one is that thermoplastic, it can be, once it will be set, it can be set again and again. This one, it cannot be set again and again. It means in case of a thermoplastic, remold of the shape of the plastic can occur, but in case of a thermosetting, it cannot be remolded again. Thermoplastic is quite, you can say, not this much harder or stronger, but in case of a thermosetting, it is harder and stronger comparatively to that of the thermoplastic here. Example in case of a thermoplastic, student, is PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride is there, or polystyrene is there, or polythene is there. In case of the thermoplastic, thermosetting plastic, you see bakelite is there and melamine is there. Okay, so this is the two different type of plastics. Okay, thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Now let us see that what are the different properties. It means in general, what is the properties of plastics? So, properties of plastics. Now, let us see that what are the different properties of plastic. Numerous properties are there. A lot of properties of plastic is there, and that will make the plastic superior over the other material. Although we are knowing that what is the harmful effect or useful effect, that is the one thing. But the property of the plastic, it make it superior than that of the other material. Now, what are the these different properties? So, the first one is resistant to chemical. Resistant to chemicals. Yes. You see, student, if suppose you will use any other thing, a cloth is there or any other material, so that can be get affected by that of the chemicals. But if you look at the plastic, so the plastic will not going to react with the chemical, so there will be no such bad impact occur with that of the chemical. You see, student, if suppose you are keeping the chemical in a metal container, then what will happen? The metal will start reacting with the chemical. But in case of a plastic, they are resistant. Okay, they will not going to react with it. Okay, so not only this, if suppose you if they are coming in contact with the chemical regularly or easily, even then also you will find that they will not get corrode. Corrosion, you have seen the rusting of the iron, you have heard about the rusting of iron. So basically the iron, when it is exposed to that of the air, so coming in contact with the air, will air and moisture will make it to react with the air, make it to react with the water, and ultimately corrosion occur. But in case of a plastic, no such corrosion will be seen. Okay, so we can write it that plastic are resistant to chemicals. Resistance to the chemicals. Resistance to chemicals and do not get corroded easily. Okay, it is resistance to chemical and do not get corroded easily. Now this is because they are used for packaging or storage of the chemicals. Because of this property, they can be the chemicals usually stored in that of the plastics. Okay, so we can also write it that they are used to make packages for storing chemical. Next one is strength. So plastics, they are flexible, they are lightweight, and they are stronger. Okay, so we can say that, and durable also, durability is also there. So you can see lightweight, strong is there, durable is there. So absolutely these property make it makes the plastic more stronger, or we can say more effective than that of the other material. Okay, so plastics are stronger. They are stronger, lightweight. They are stronger, lightweight, and durable. Okay, and because of that only, student, you see these days the plastic are replacing the metal objects. Okay, so instead of using the metal object, we used to prefer that of the plastic object. So we can also write it here, and that is they are slowly replacing parts of the machine. Okay. As well as the body objects, like car, washing machine. So you see, students, the outer covering of the washing machine or the car or the fridge, basically it is made up of a plastic. Okay, so because of lightweight, because of having strength, means stronger, and having the durability, okay, for a long period of a time, so they are nowadays they are replaced by that of the metal object. Okay, as well as it is also used for the outer covering, for that of the different kind of equipments or products. Next one is thermal conductivity. They are very poor conductor of a thermal, it means heat. So thermal conductivity, it means the heat, how heat is moving. So you see, metals are a very good conductor of heat. But if you look at the plastics, so plastics are the bad conductor or a poor conductor. So basically they are insulator of heat. And that is why they are used, even you see in the utensils, so the handles are basically made up of a plastic. Not only this, students, a lot of equipment that we use, they are made up of a plastic, so that it will not going to hurt us, because they are insulator of heat. Okay. So we can write it next one, that is thermal conductivity. So we can say that plastics are insulator of heat. What is an insulator? It means it do not allow heat to pass through it. Okay, so we can say that they are the insulator. Okay, now anything, if anything, if you are having gloves which is made up of a plastic, and when you touch a hot utensil, you will not going to feel it. It is because the heat do not pass through it. Okay, it will not pass through that of the plastic. So they are insulator of heat, and this is because they are used for making dishes, used in microwave oven. Okay, it is used in making the dishes that is used in the microwave oven, as well as the handles for cooking utensils. Okay, so handles in cooking that of the utensils, that is also used in the, and that is also made up of the plastics. Because you know the students, if something utensils are generally made up of a metals. So from where we have to, if suppose we want to keep it, or if we want to handle that utensils, that handle, it should be made up of a plastic, because plastic is a insulator. Okay. Now they are also used insulating materials in the refrigerator. Okay, for cooling. Okay, so we can also say that they are the insulator of heat, and due to which they are also used in insulating the material in refrigerator. So they are also used as insulating materials, in a refrigerator as well as in the air conditioner, okay, so it is used as an insulating material in refrigerator as well as in the air conditioner. Okay, so you can see here, students, that how the plastic property, that is thermal conductivity, is useful. They are insulator of heat, as well as because of the insulation, they are used for making such kind of dishes or utensils that can be used in the microwave oven, as well as the handles are also made up of the plastic. So this is the next property, and that is the thermal conductivity. So are they only insulator of the heat, or are they insulator of the electricity also? Yes, they are not a good conductor, they are insulator of the heat, as well as they are the insulator of the electricity. So heat cannot pass through it, as well as the electricity will not going to pass through it. So they are a very poor conductor, you can say, or they are, and this is because you see the electrical equipments, their handle is made up of plastics. We used to wear the plastic gloves or our slippers so that we will not get the shock from it. Okay, so we can say that the electrical conductivity, students, and here the next one after thermal conductivity is electrical conductivity. Okay, electrical conductivity. So we can here say that plastics are insulator of electricity also. Insulator of electricity also. It means it do not allow electricity to pass through it. Okay. Now, in the next class today, we will see that some of the other properties of the plastic, as well as we will also try to understand that how this electrical conductivity of the properties of the plastic is good for us. Okay.